Hi, I'm Kristen Politi. I'm here today with Altimmune President and CEO Bill Enright and Chief Financial Officer Elizabeth Czerepak. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Same here.
Bill, do you want to start off by talking about Altimmune and what the company is trying to do?
Altimmune is a clinical stage immunotherapeutics company. We're developing a couple of very interesting clinical stage candidates we call NasoVAX and HepTcell for seasonal flu and chronic hepatitis B. And we're really trying to harness the body's immune system to treat these diseases both prophylactically for seasonal flu and therapeutically for chronic hepatitis B.
Elizabeth, can you start us off by giving a financial history of the company?
So we had a recent merger with Pharmathene, in which we were able to list on NASDAQ on May 5th of this year.
Congratulations.
And thank you. We started off the merger with about $20 million in cash. And of that, it was included an incremental investment by Novartis Ventures, which is one of our insiders.
Bill, I know you have two lead programs in seasonal flu and you mentioned in hepatitis B. Do you want to start by telling me about your program in seasonal flu?
About 40,000 people in the U.S. alone die every year from seasonal flu. About the same number as breast cancer every year. It's a major issue. You know, the current vaccines that we have on the market really don't work very well. So about 40% average efficacy over a 10-year period. And that's really because the virus, you know, it mutates all the time. So it takes a while to make the flu vaccine. By the time it gets made, it doesn't always match the strain that's actually circulating. The seasonal flu program, NasoVAX, is really designed to differentiate and overcome those issues with the current flu vaccines.
That's very interesting. Do you want to tell me a little bit about the technology behind that?
So we're using an adenovirus platform, intranasally administered, so no more shots. And the adenovirus allows us to really stimulate multiple arms of the immune system. And what we're seeing in our preclinical models, at least, is that we can get protection as quickly as a day or two after administering the vaccine. Most vaccines take 2 to 3 weeks before they're protective. And that protection is really broad. You can vaccinate against one strain of flu and protect against many strains of flu, so universal-like activity. So really a paradigm shift in the flu vaccine space. We're currently getting set to enroll a phase 2 clinical study, and we expect data from that study in the first quarter of 2018.
So in terms of those trials, what's the goal of the phase 2?
The key goal is always safety, and we're also then trying to look at immunogenicity. So we're going to be looking specifically at the strain that we're using to vaccinate and showing that we get a good immune response against that strain. But then we're also looking more broadly at many different strains to see if we can see this broad protection that we're seeing in our preclinical models. The second half of the trial, the part B, is really to look at that early response. And so in order to do that, you really have to know exactly when you got the flu. So we do this in a challenge model where you give people the vaccine, and then a few days later, you give them flu and see if they're protected from the flu.
When I think of seasonal flu trials, I think of big trials. What are the numbers like there?
We get that question a lot. And to give you some perspective on the size of our trials, we expect with our first clinical trial to be able to evaluate a breadth of immune response in a relatively small trial of only 60 subjects. And that will be followed up by the challenge study that Bill referred to, and that also will be about 60 subjects. As far as our plans for phase 3, we have reason to believe that our numbers in those trials will be much more along the lines of small thousands of subjects versus 10,000 trials that I believe you're referring to.
I want to transition to talking about your program in hepatitis B. So what are you trying to do in hepatitis B space?
So really we're trying to provide a cure for hepatitis B. So hepatitis B is a major problem. About 240 million people around the world chronically infected with hepatitis B. And about a million people a year dying from cirrhosis and cancer of the liver as a direct result of Hep B infections. So we think we have a potential cure for hepatitis B. This immunotherapeutic actually is designed to stimulate the body's immune system, the T cell part of the immune system, so that it recognizes the infected cells and kills them.
That's a big goal. So do you want to tell us about the technology, where you differentiate yourselves in that space?
So we're right now in phase one testing, and we hope to have data from that study in the fourth quarter of this year. But the technology is really designed around a synthetic peptide technology, and we're using that to really jumpstart the body's immune system. Because the way hepatitis B works is it kind of tricks the body into thinking that the virus isn't there. So you've got to really kind of overcome that and convince the body that it is there and to recognize those infected cells and kill them.
It sounds like you have two really interesting programs, both in the NasoVAX and the HepTcell. Elizabeth, can you tell me a little bit about how you plan to fund the development of these programs?
Well, we expect that the estimated $20 million that we had on hand at the time of the merger will be sufficient to sustain the achievement of the key clinical milestones that Bill has described, and that gets us through second quarter 2018 for funding.
Bill, do you have anything else you want to mention to give us a full picture of Altimmune as a company?
So the HepTcell and NasoVAX programs are really what we look at as the value drivers for the company. But in addition to that, we have a very competitive position in the anthrax vaccine space. So we've got two different anthrax vaccine programs that are fully funded by the U.S. government. We've received about $140 million in U.S. government contracts to develop these different vaccines.
Thank you very much, Bill and Elizabeth, for joining us today.
Absolutely appreciate it. You know, it's a really exciting time for the company. We've got a lot of interesting results coming out in the next 12 to 18 months, and I think we're really well positioned for growth and got a great team on board, and we're excited about the future of the company.